Hello, ladies. How's it going this morning so far?
Pretty great,
Pretty
yeah.
great. Pretty great.
Well, good, good, good. Well, listen, congratulations on this fabulous series. I love it. And I mean, who doesn't love Stephen King? Really? Come on.
Jerks.
Yeah, that one guy who hates Stephen King,
What
that
a
guy.
jerk.
Yeah.
We won't talk to him.
Yeah.
This,
You
I'm
better not.
telling you. Yeah, that's for sure. Listen, this is so wonderful. And Elsie, I mean, I have to start with you because after seeing your performance in eighth grade, I thought this is now, no offense, Lizzie, but Elsie, you're now my new favorite actress, honestly. You're just
I
so
concur.
fantastic.
Oh,
And
that's very sweet.
I wanted to know, like, when you jumped into the role of Joy, how elated, how excited, how nervous were you to take this character on?
Oh, so nervous. I mean, eighth grade was a big deal for me because I've been working for a long time, but that was the most like serious thing I've really been in, even though it was fun. So
Yes.
yeah, jumping into this, and there was a pretty big gap in between working on this and on that. Yeah, it was very nerve-wracking, and I wasn't sure what to expect or really kind of the type of people I was going to be working with. And thankfully, it ended up being a really fantastic experience, both enjoyment-wise and in learning-wise. And it's been pretty excellent, I will say.
Absolutely. And then Lizzie, you get to work with Elsie, and it's a mom and daughter relationship. Not quite the usual mom and daughter relationship, right? It's a different. But what was it like for you to have her step into this role and work with her, and what impressed you about her?
I was very, very excited when I found out that Elsie was going to be playing Joy. I've been a fan of Tim Robbins my entire life, but as soon as I found out that Elsie Fisher was going to be in the movie, I only cared about being with Elsie Fisher. Like, Eighth Grade, I think, is the best movie of last year. I think she's incredibly amazing in it, like insanely talented. I was so pumped. And then I met her, and she's like normal and nice and ridiculously talented, but like not caught up and not. I don't know another teenage actress that has had the kinds of success that Elsie has had that isn't at least 30% monster,
I'm only
usually more.
25, so.
Hardly. You're a single digit monster.
Yeah. But, Elsie, listen, I sat with you at the Critics' Choice Awards last year. I was at your table. I'm a member.
Good to hear
Yes, I sat
from
like, just right next to you. And you won. I mean, rightfully so. What's life been like for you? Or is it just, you go on and you work and then things are normal?
No, I mean it's been pretty different and great. I mean, I've obviously been in Massachusetts for 7 months, so it's been different. Yeah, but it's just been the best, and I feel like I'm having a really like almost too good to be true life right now. Like, I'm surrounded by good people who support me, and I'm like working on things I enjoy that end up being kind of cool and good. Like, okay, what's gonna happen? Like, where does the bad part start? Because it's gotta start at some point.
Oh, it'll happen,
Oh yeah,
Elsie.
I'll have my
Don't
crash.
worry.
2020, Elsie, you'll see her. She'll be in the dumpsters.
Yeah, dumpster by
Lizzie,
2021.
you are so good in this role, honestly. And it must have been for you hard to take on such an iconic character like Annie Wilkes, because she is one of the most popular, famous, Stephen King characters, but you get to kind of mold her into your own. How stressful has it been playing her? Because there's some intense stuff going on for you.
Yeah, for whatever reason, I found it was obviously more challenging at the beginning, slipping into Annie Wilkes's shoes, but as the season went on, I found it easier and easier to just access her particular brand of, I won't say crazy, I'll say agitation. And so in watching it now, watching the finished episodes, yeah, it looks like, God, how that doesn't look sustainable for the amount of time that we were there to operate at that frequency. But for whatever reason, I guess because it was really fun making this show, it never felt too overwhelming. It really didn't. I mean, I definitely had a mini panic attack every night for like the first 2 months, but
Ah, that's
yeah.
standard.
Yeah, that's nothing new.
Yeah, who doesn't? You wouldn't be normal if you didn't have those panic attacks. Elsie, what have you learned from your co-star
I
there?
mean, what haven't I learned? Oh my God. I learned how to be a strong woman.
How to swim, how to read.
Yes. how to talk.
How to speak English.
I couldn't speak before this, so this was a really enlightening experience. Now I have, conscious thought.
Yeah.
And that's really different and exciting. So.
That's what I do.
Thank you, Lizzie.
You're welcome.
So nice. But it must be difficult for the two of you because you playing such different, like this odd relationship on screen, and then off screen, obviously your buddies, your pals. Like, is it hard to kind of disassociate and just get into this acting, you know, and just leave that aside?
I think it makes it easier. I've always found that, like, if you have a real relationship with somebody, then you feel more comfortable trying things, and it frees you up.
It's easier to, you know, try new things. Yeah, and I think, you know, especially in this where it's a mother and daughter, it's like they're going through some stuff right now, for sure. But also they've lived with each other their entire lives. They have their inside jokes. They love each other. Like, there is a lot of, you know, there's a good relationship deep down. It's just this town sucks and Annie needs to a good diagnosis. And, you know.
It's the town.
Yeah, it's just the town, really.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Well, you can blame everything on the town. I mean, Castle Rock, come on, for sure. So fans are very excited. I mean, bittersweet. It's the finale, but it's, you know, it's exciting. What kind of teaser can you give us for fans to look forward to?
I mean, what can't you look forward to? I think there's a lot of content in the finale.
Yes.
We shot a lot of stuff.
Yes, we did. We don't know what the finished product will actually be, but we are very optimistic that it will be a satisfying conclusion to this season.
Exactly.
Well, good stuff. We look forward to it. And best of luck to both of you. Such a great series. And thanks for this. It's wonderful. Great talking to you,
you
ladies.
Too.
Thank you.
Yeah.